The best way to use an electric car is to charge it for long periods when parked. However, it's not always cheap or possible to install charging points in places such as condominiums. Companies rarely have policies to encourage staff to come by electric car and charge it at work. For many, the only option is to use the public network. There is no standard policy to promote the installation of private charging stations in existing and new buildings. One solution could be access to public funding for old building owners to install private or shared chargers. The best incentives for electric mobility are to support the private charger network and free up the public network for long trips, occasional needs, and consumers with no other solution, ensuring and simplifying the installation of private slow charging points. In the public network, the main concern is the time needed to recharge. This cannot take long or be a waste of time. Regular chargers take from 2 to 6 times longer to charge than a fast charger. There are very few fast chargers. No more than 7% of chargers provide 42 kilowatt hours. It's a tiny number, and most of them are on motorways. There needs to be many more fast chargers in towns and cities to ensure a higher turnover of users. One fast charger, 42 kilowatt hours, can represent 2 to 3 regular chargers, 11 kilowatt hours, taking into account simultaneous charging needs. We believe there should be fewer slow chargers. Cities have to start installing and converting the public network to chargers with more than 22 kilowatt hours and create fast and ultra-fast charger points. Long journeys require reliable networks in terms of availability and speed. We expected to find service stations with fast chargers on all motorways and main roads. But we came across very different and dramatic scenarios. For example, in Italy, not all service areas had charging stations. We were forced to leave the motorway to find the nearest station, but there was always some uncertainty. On motorways in Portugal, a reasonable number of service areas already have fast chargers, but there is usually only one charging point. The main highways and motorways should be equipped with fast and ultra-fast chargers at all service stations. All new stations should be above 50 kilowatt hours or even 150 kilowatt hours. Each charging station should have enough charging points for the number of vehicles they expect there and always provide more than a single point. On leaving the main routes and entering the secondary roads, we discovered exceptionally few chargers. In some cases, we only found one charger in the main towns. Given the chance of it being in use or broken down, the next charging point may be a long way away in the next main town. In some areas, that can be more than 100 kilometers. This is the average range of a small electric car. In Spain, we faced the worst-case scenario. In the northern hinterland, you may have to drive 170 kilometers to find a charging station. In Italy, between Florence and Rome, it was 120 kilometers between chargers. The availability of charging stations in densely populated areas is in stark contrast to the hinterland. But nothing justifies a total lack of charging points. Consumers demand a national network in all regions, however distant and isolated they may be. No region can be left out of electric mobility, and it is unacceptable that you can go more than 50 kilometers on roads outside cities without finding a charger. Except for Portugal, countries don't guarantee interoperability between charging stations, apart from occasional agreements. Consumers must be able to use the entire network, regardless of the brand, using just one energy supplier card. Unfortunately, in practice, consumers are forced to contract 2, 3, or even more energy suppliers to ensure that they can use the next station. Portugal could serve as an excellent example with a universal payment system. The state-owned Mobi.e covers all service station providers and operators. Consumers can contract the provider they like and use the same mobility card at all stations. Payment should be practical in each country and across Europe. Public stations should also provide the possibility to pay by debit and credit card. No country lets you charge your car without having a contract with the provider or application with registration and credit card. Occasional users, such as tourists or if you forget your mobile phone or card, require payment in the usual methods, with a credit or debit card, cash or a prepaid card. Making occasional payment easier is the very least they could do. Drivers never know how much the charge will cost them. The price includes the electricity and different charger tariffs depending on time or power. The final price and conditions are not clear. Clear information about the price of energy and the tariffs must be guaranteed. There is a lack of regulation and standardization of the criteria for tariffs and extra charges. Apps can improve the experience. We used support apps in all countries that showed a map of the charger stations, but not everything went smoothly. It was never easy to find the charger marked on the map in Portugal and Belgium, or know whether it was working before you got there. In countries with app payments, the system does not always work. In Belgium and Italy, we had to call the operator to have the connection approved and start charging. Apps are a great tool, making charging more accessible and helping you plan your trip. A common data communication protocol should be created among all charging stations. Only then will apps provide reliable data such as exact location, availability, operation, price, and online booking about all operators. For as long as these basic requirements are not met, electric mobility will not smile on everyone's face.